up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be talking to you about 5 ways to deal with defiant students. The students who tend to not want to listen to direction, who always say no, who seem to be the class clown in your class, or it's just really difficult to connect with them. I'm sure for some of you who are teachers, you already are imagining and picturing a student in your mind. A lot of people say that there are certain names they would never name their child when they have a baby because they are just so strongly associate the name with negative student. So these are some ways that I use in my classroom to try to help the student, because honestly, if they are not listening in the classroom, they're not going to want to learn anything. I'm house sitting right now, and I kid you not, I order from MILK&EGGS like every week, and it really changed my life because they have so many things that I can buy and I don't have to go to the store and go to different places, because usually I only go to Trader Joe's and then MILK&EGGS. MILK&EGGS pretty much has everything I need. So I'm just gonna quickly show you guys my favorite things. Oat milk. This was my first time trying oat milk and I really liked it. One of my students told me they love eating their cereal with oat milk out of any other milk. So I tried it. It's delicious. You should get it. Next is cream cheese. I don't eat dairy, so this is a vegan cream cheese and it's chive. It's really good. They used to have jalapeno, which I loved, but they got rid of it. So this is like a close second, I guess. And then my favorite eggs, they're so good, are these organic free-range eggs. Is there really a difference between the regular white eggs that you buy at like Target versus these organic, pasture-raised, free-range? Yes, there is a difference in the yolk color and the amount of nutrients that are in them. I really like it, especially for hard-boiled eggs, and I just feel like it tastes much more fresh and doesn't feel like I'm eating chemicals. If you wanna try it out, my code Maya Lee will get you guys $20 off $40. So basically you're getting $40 worth of groceries for $20. Yeah, it's great. So first we need to remember that students and people are the way they are for a reason. We don't really always know what the reason is, but 99% of the time that I've encountered a student who's being difficult, it's because something's going on in the family. I've also noticed this happens more so in older kids than in younger kids, because younger kids can be defiant, but they also are afraid of getting in trouble, while some kids, as they grow up, they don't even care if they're in trouble or not. That's really sad. We need them to care, not so much about pleasing people, but about following the expectations that are put on them. Okay, so let's get started. Number one, as hard as it is, give the students positive feedback as much as you can. Find a compliment you can give the student so that when they do something wrong, they're not constantly feeling like you always target them. Try to find a compliment that you can give the student every single day. I know it might be difficult sometimes, but even just telling them like, hey, great job following directions quickly, or look at him already starting his work. Just find anything so that they know you're not targeting them. Number two, finding alone time to try to talk to the student. Because I've noticed that a lot of times when a kid is being defiant with me, in front of their peers, they're going to act out even more because they want to seem cool and they want to seem like, ha, I'm so funny. So even when you're passing down the hallway with the students, just go talk to them and say, hey, how was your weekend? Or try to get more personal of how was your sibling's basketball game, or just things that you hear about the student. Try to say, show them that you remember about them so that they know you care. Because I know it's not really about students liking you, but honestly, if they like you, they will listen to you more. Number three, when they do act out, try to send the student outside and then give them words of affirmation of, hey, you're out here because these were the expectations and you did not meet them. It's not because I don't like you, it's because this is what I expect from you because you can do it. You are better. You can do this as a student. So giving them that type of feedback will allow them to register, I need to take ownership over what I just did, not so much as, oh, this teacher just doesn't like me. Four, find ways to connect with the student, because when they feel like you are trying to connect with them, then they know you care. So for me, it was getting into Fortnite or looking at these gamers or finding topics that the students really enjoy and just looking it up and then asking them questions about it of, hey, so what is this really about? Then they can feel like, oh, I can actually talk to an adult about this. Number five, try not to call them out in front of everybody. I know it's hard sometimes, especially when we're in the moment. We don't have time to step outside. For me, if I do step outside, I'm halfway in the classroom and outside because I still need to watch my kids while I'm talking to the student, but I talk in a manner where hopefully not everyone can hear. But just that gesture shows of like, hey, so-and-so, can you step outside for a second? And then just talk to them so that they're not embarrassed in front of the whole entire grade and that they're not labeled as the bad kid. Because once they're labeled, then they might just run with it. And that's what we don't want. We want them to know they're a great kid and that they can exceed the expectations that are put on them if someone believes in them. So these are just the 5 steps that I've used in my classrooms to try to get students on a better track. And a lot of them just need a lot of love. They need to know they're cared for. They need to know that it matters. What they're doing really matters. And that's something I'm still working on. Please let me know if you have any questions or you need advice on anything, and I'll try my best to answer based on the experience that I've had so far. PS tip, I guess this is a bonus tip. Something I've noticed is that a lot of kids who have family issues at home, they kind of will voice it in the classroom, whether it's them saying, you know, I don't really know who's picking me up today, or I never really know who's picking me up, or things like that where you catch on of, I wonder why. It's okay to ask them like, hey, like, if you ever need anyone to talk to, I'm here for you, or how come? And just kind of hearing about them and letting them vent out to you, that kind of shows that they can trust you as an adult. And then because of that bond, they'll latch on to you and will want to listen to what you're saying because they know you are someone that they respect and trust. If you like what you see, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you later.